I'm a Youth Olympic Games athlete heading to Argentina later this year. And today I'm in Nelson visiting New Zealand's oldest living Olympian, Ngaire Galloway, who's also my grandma.
I don't think I can give you any advice on swimming. It's all changed a bit, hasn't it? The stroke itself has changed a lot. Gina's lucky, she's got killer instinct, good competitor.
Thank you.
In our day we thought we were training hard, but it was incredible how little we did compared with what you people do.
Yeah.
What's your schedule?
Busy, that's for sure. I'm training 8 sessions in the water and 4 gyms in a week, yeah.
So what time do you start with your swimming in the water?
I get up at 4:45, 3 mornings a week, and then I start training at 5:30 to 7, and then I go to school. Then after school I have training about 4 till 7:30.
You've got to be focused to do that. A sort of a longing, really, inside me. I look at Gina swimming and think, golly, the stroke's changed a bit, quite a bit, really, hasn't it, Gina? But all the tuition and the training has brought her so far forward from where I was at times. I don't think I had killer instinct, really.
How much training would you have done and compared to what Gina does now?
Oh, it was so minimal, it's incredible. I was a secretary at the city council, and I'd go down to the pool for my lunchtime, and in between as many lengths as I could pack in, I'd have to have my lunch and be back at work. And I used to go down, not many people went at 6:30 in the morning, but towards the end I used to go down at 6:30 and do as many lengths as I could. I had a good trainer, or I'd never have gone as far as I did. I was lucky. Don Watson was a very, very good trainer. But of course when I got to England I didn't have anybody. I was the only New Zealand swimmer. How would you like to be the only one?
Thanks to technology we have today, she's able to live stream into the races I'm doing, and Dad always sends her the link so she can watch, and it's always cool knowing that she's watching from Nelson. My dad has been very inspiring. I remember from a young age listening to all her stories of her travels, the friends she's made, and the experiences she's gained from swimming. And ever since a young age, Dad made sure I learnt how to swim. And so I think it came naturally, the love of swimming, and you know, the shared bond we have over swimming and the sport has been really, really inspiring, and has definitely motivated me to continue to swim to this day. Yeah.
That's a nice thought.